Hey everyone, Tankenstein here. In this video, I'll be doing a very quick but still very informative review of the Buccaneer S1, the Tier 6 British Event Strike aircraft that sits at 8.7 PR in RP and 9.7 PR in AB. This is the top reward for the summer landing event in 2021. As such, I'll go over its important details and then give you a final recommendation on if you should own it or not. I'm trying to make this review ultra quick, but obviously still very informative because, for one, it's a strike aircraft that has no capabilities to do anything else, so there isn't much to talk about in regards to it, and for two, I'm experimenting with a quick review format where I talk quickly enough where I can get around 7 to 8 minutes of info into around 3 to 5 minutes of a normal talking speed review. That said, let me know how it is in the comments below if you like this format, but either way, let's get into the review. So to start, let's go over its stats. As a top speed of 1,105 kilometers per hour in RB and 1,115 kilometers per hour in AB, 32 second turn time, and a 42 meter per second rate of climb. These are both in RB, and it's not much better in AB at 30.2 seconds for turn time and 51.2 meters per second rate of climb. And that does not feel like 51.2 meters per second. Bear in mind that these are when the S1 is fully upgraded as well. It also has up to 16 loadout presets, including room for RP3 and RN rockets, two different types of 1,000 pound bombs, and AGM-12B bullpups. It has a max bomb yield of around 2,169 kilograms of explosive mass, which is fairly respectable and will help the grind tremendously if you play Air AB and also Air RB. Speaking of this plane is essentially just a two-trick pony, as are most bombers. You can use it versus tanks and you can use it versus bases. That's about it. Fulfills both roles quite well, but has absolutely no defenses in the form of armament or even simple countermeasures. With a built-in ballistics computer, you can find CAS with bombs might be more effective than with bullpups or rockets, especially if you're not good at aiming them, as I'm not. It also features up to 4 LDHE MC Mark 1 1,000 pound bombs, which have around 50% more explosive force than the internally carried GP Mark 1 bombs. Aside from CAS, you'll basically just operate as a base destroyer. Depending on the map, you can be incredibly successful in this role in RB and in AB, where I feel that it has its highest potential for RP and Silverline earnings. You'll basically need to time it where you use the S1 once all the planes with a high rate of climb or advanced missiles are gone from the enemy team. Once their Harriers, F-104s, MiG-19s, MiG-21s, and similar planes are either gone or tied up in other fights, that's the time to use the S1 and AB. Just side climb and you should have a decentish survival rate of around 40-60% while you try to enjoy the tedium of a slow bomber that can only get around 6,500 meters above the ground before being too slow to stay aloft, all while dropping bombs on the base around every 45 seconds to a minute. The S1's gameplay is not thrilling, but it gets the job done if you're looking to grind, especially if you purchase a talisman for it. Now with its two roles out of the way, let's go over its strengths and weaknesses and tell me what you guys think about this format in the comments below. I'm interested to hear it. For its strengths, we have good selection of anti-ground ordnance, especially if you do not focus on what the S2 has to offer. Second, it has a low BR for its capabilities in RB ground and can be absolutely devastating to somebody who has high in the British ground tech tree but does not have high in the British air tech tree. It's a great stand-in close air support plane. Third, it can carry bullpups, albeit manually guided AGM-12B, so it might not be as easy for some people to use like me. I'm terrible with those things. And fourth, it has great air brakes. They will slow you down tremendously, which will help a ton in CAS and as a defensive measure, and also just for landing at base to reload. With the strengths out of the way, let's go over its weaknesses. While it's capable of destroying bases in RB air, it is totally boring and also dangerous, especially in an up tier when people can just fling missiles at you. Second, it has no defensive or offensive capabilities. You're totally at the mercy of the vehicles of the enemy team if you've been up tiered and where you are on the map. Third, while it has a surprisingly good roll rate, its agility is terrible. Fourth, it has mediocre acceleration and rate of climb in every single game mode, especially in AB air. The S2 has unupgraded engines that are around 50% more powerful than the fully upgraded engines in the S1. You can only fly in AB air once most or all supersonic enemy planes have been destroyed. Fifth, it has very rough BR placement in AB. You will face MiG-21s and F-4s regularly. This plane would work much, much better at 9.3 BR. And finally, it is not a premium vehicle, but a talisman should kind of remedy this, at least to a point, and it's a little bit expensive, but hey, it's a good grinder. And now for my final recommendation, should you own this plane? Yes, if you have nothing else for close air support, if you want a good grinder for the air tech tree, and or if you're a collector. While this plane isn't particularly particularly good. It still gets the job done with no frills. It can be devastating in a close air support role. It can provide tons of SL and RP in successful AB or RB missions. With a premium account, I see 10,000 RP easily per match using the S1 in AB. It is a difficult plane to be successful with, as it is a sitting duck in almost every sense of the term, but once the skies are clear, it can earn tons of RP and SL. While people are oftentimes focusing on the fact that this is much worse than the S2, it is also a totally different plane and sits at a lower BR. Either way, it's still incredibly capable, and while you may need to reload more often than you'll likely want, it will still do the job in ground RP and earn you tons of planes in the air tech tree. Just make sure that there aren't many threats in the sky, otherwise you'll meet a quick end while flying the Buccaneer S1. For reference, I give it a 7 out of 10 for grinding, largely because it's so easy to kill and because it's not a premium, an 8 out of 10 for close air support, a 2 out of 10 for versatility, and about a 6.5 out of 10 for overall value. I recommend the S1, but only for people who need a good grinder or close air support plane for the British. I wouldn't buy it for any more than 40 or 45 GJM, depending on how much you need it. Either way, thanks so much for watching, everyone. Please let me know what you thought about this format, and if you think it's good, bad, whatever it is, in the comments below. Please like and subscribe as well, as they both help tremendously. Either way, thanks again, and I'll see you all on the other side. Take care, everyone.